Now I'll give you a play-by-play description, description and explanation of each of the moves in the technique. The first move begins, we'll just do the arms first because it'll be simpler. The left arm goes out. The left arm goes out with the elbow being, with the wave traveling through the arm, through the elbow, to the wrist, to the fingers and the palm of the hand, and then bring the arm in along the line of the heart. At the same time as the arm, the left arm is coming forward, the right arm is coming out in a knife edge strike. Feel the elbow pull down. And so you do both of these arm movements at the same time. One. One. At first you can practice it by doing one, two. But eventually, they happen at once. At the same time as you're doing these this first arm move, you are taking a step out to the side. You start off standing straight, and you step out to the side, dropping into a turned-in deep stance. Here, you want to make sure that the knee is on top of the ankle bone, and this leg is straight. Be careful that when you're doing this pose, that the outside edge of your foot is not coming up off the ground, and even though your knee is straight, and you have a tendency, you have a natural desire for the leg to turn in, keep turning out the thigh. Same thing with this leg. Even though it's turned in and you'll have a natural tendency to let the knee drop like this, keep turning the thigh out. Let's put both moves together. So we'll do the hands and the feet at the same time. And one, together. Let's do that again. And out, step out to the side with the arms. Excellent. The second move, and again, we'll break this down in terms of arms and legs. For the second move, you're here. Bring the hand underneath your arm. Bring the left hand underneath the upper arm of the right arm. Then thread the elbow of the right arm over the forearm of your left hand, or your left arm. Reach up. Simply bring the elbow above your head with the palm turning up towards the sky. Turn the right hand so that the inside part of the arm faces front. Now imagine that I'm pulling on a rope with my left arm, and that rope is tied around a winch. So as I pull back with my left arm, my right arm is pulled forward. That's the action of the arms. The action that's happening at the same time with the legs is as so. I've stepped out to the side in the first move, and in the second move, I simply turn my legs out and I shift the weight. So let's do that again, just the legs. Drop out to the side, turn the legs out, and shift the weight. Let's do the second move with the arms and the legs together. So I'm here, turned in, arm, legs. One more time. Arms, legs. Excellent. Let's do the first move and the second move all at the same time. And don't forget, they have really exotic kung fu names. So let's give them names. Let's call it dragon, no, block, dragon strike block. Sure, dragon strike block. We call it phoenix draws water. Ooh, I like that name. All right, and now we have Russian bull collapses. Very good, excellent. Maybe they should be related to the dragon, eh? So sub-earth dragon on the crust of the earth. Dives. No. Sub-earth dragon resting on the earth. Sub-earth dragon on a cloudy day. Wow, it works. Okay, so you're here. All right, great. The next move is called sub-earth dragon dives into the core of the earth. You're here in this position, and your hands sweep the inside of a sphere. and you're chasing your left leg. You're chasing your tail. Why? Because you're a dragon, and that's what dragons do for fun. You hear? Boom. And you chase your tail, and your tail, well, it does what all tails do, escapes. Right, so you're here, and move your, chase your tail, your tail escapes, and it brings you up, yeah, let's do it like this, brings you up into, what is it called in yoga? Some sort of standing leg yoga, dog posture thing, and up with a turned in leg and flexed foot. Do not have the leg turned out, do not point the foot. We're going to do that later. Boom, here you are. Okay? This is for beginners. In the intermediate, module 2, you go from dragon on a cloudy day into a full handstand. With a full handstand with an L position, with your legs in L position. Alright, so here we are, dragon on a cloudy day, into dog posture with leg up, into a Gurdjieff push-up. Why don't we do that facing you so you can see what we're doing? So we'll just change direction. Alright, how does that happen? Let's just face you and do it. So we're here. Here on this side, you come down, bringing your knee over your elbow with your knee flexed at first, and then extending out to the side. And you do push-ups while flexing and extending knee, and flexing and pointing the foot. You do 3 in the beginner version, 7 in the more advanced version, then kick the leg back into the dog posture, whatever yoga name it has. Then, out in second position, turn the leg out and turn the hips open to the front. Then, out in second position, or as we like to call it, dog peeing over a fire hydrant. Then, touch the toes to the head. This also has a yoga name, which I don't know what it is.
Scorpion.
Who cares? And bring the knee in, then we do a move called weaving the knee. You bring the leg in. You cross the left leg, the top, the moving leg, across your standing leg. Keep it as far crossed over the standing leg as possible, and then turn the leg open, but don't bring it across. Then bring it across, and do an undulatory push-up. And then dragon spread its wings, summer dragon spread its wings in the molten core of the earth, looking up on a nice bright sunny day. It's a very long name, but we like it. Alright, you do this on the other side, then you sit down, summer dragon having tea, and from the seated position, uncurl the body. Let your arms, let natural momentum of the twisting spine carry your arms and that whips your body around into a full handstand with your legs this time in the splits, not in the L position. You come down in the plank position and reach back for the leg with the same side arm into whatever yoga name this position has. Then reach back with the foot. This will cause you to arch your back fully. Use that as the beginning of a full rippling undulation of the spine. Coming up. And release. Now the opposite arm is holding the lifted leg. And then. I always think of an Air Force, Navy, fighter plane when I think of this pose, which is probably not very yoga-centered mind of me, but whatever. And you're in this pose and turn and back. Grabbing the leg from underneath, with the same side arm, with a side thrust foot where the foot is beveled, and bringing the arm on the same plane as the leg. Then bring the leg in, lift the arm up straight to the side, as straight as you can. Then bring the leg in, one more time, bring it forward, come up on the ball of your foot, release the leg, then step down. Come down in the python bow, into an iron cross, grab the rings of the iron cross, and pretend you're an Olympic gold medalist gymnast. And then come down, and Black Panther bow, the triangles, wings of the dragon spread, and adopt the neuters. And that completes our instruction of Sub-Earth Dragon Yoga Volume Module 1. Allison?
Yes, Stephen?
That was a beautiful form.
Yes, it was. Thank you for doing it.
Thank you for doing it. Hey, how are they going to know which one of the two of us did the form?
That'll just be our little secret.
Thank you very much.